Hey, welcome. We're glad you're with us today. Our reading is at Lamentations chapter 3, verses 52 to 54. Let's hear from the Word of God, and then let's just think about it together. Here's what it says. My enemies without cause hunted me down like a bird. They silenced my life in the pit and threw stones at me. The waters flowed over my head. I said, I'm cut off. So remember that chapter 3 is very autobiographical, right? This is Jeremiah telling us how he feels. And being a prophet must have been a very challenging emotional kind of experience because there's all the things you want to see, you want to help the people with. You want to be, of course, faithful to all the message God has that he wants you to give. And yet the people are oblivious. The people are like, they just completely don't get it. And so these are some of the things you're balancing and really finding it hard to sort out. And I think verse 52 really helps us here. My enemies without cause hunted me down like a bird. Well, they had cause. They had cause. They didn't have just cause, but they had cause. They thought that Jeremiah was wrong. They thought that he was too rigid. He was much too conservative, or whatever you would say. He was much too religious. He was much too orthodox. But there was a cause. My enemies without cause. They didn't have a just cause, and they hunted Jeremiah down. And that's what bothered Jeremiah. There really wasn't a good reason for them to have this reaction to him. Of course, he was speaking on God's behalf as a prophet, but he wasn't the source. He was just the messenger. And you know the saying, don't shoot the messenger. That comes from people responding to the messenger this way. But they had no real reason to be unhappy with Jeremiah. They silenced my life in the pit and threw stones at me. The waters flowed over my head. I said, I'm cut off. This is how Jeremiah felt. At one point, he was actually placed in the miry pit in the bottom of a well, in the bottom of a cistern, and left there to basically die of starvation. So this, you could see the feeling going on here. They're trying to kill me, and all I am is the messenger. But he's trying not to moan and complain, but he's crying out to God. Lamentations is Jeremiah crying out to God and inspired by God. And he's telling us, all the readers, all the listeners, how he feels. And it's rough. It's rough going. The waters flowed over my head. He said, I think I'm going to die down here. I think I'm going to just die serving God. And you know, some people do die serving God. But if we're faithful, we'll have a better resurrection. That's what the New Testament says. So we can understand Jeremiah's feelings, and this sort of gives us that insight how hard it must be to try to continue. You're trying to help people come to the right place, but they're just stuck in their sins. Oh, sin is so deadly, we must avoid it at all costs. Now, what lesson might we draw from this? When those who make themselves your enemies crush you and harass you and persecute you, cry out to God for help. That's what Jeremiah did, and that's what we may need to do. Certainly, it's what we need to do. He will be our helper. He'll be our encouragement. He'll be our strength in times when we feel all alone and just going to die in the bottom of a black pit where there's nothing except death. We can cry out to God. He'll hear our prayer. Let's pray together. Dear Father in heaven, we will face times of discouragement in your service. And because of that, you allowed Jeremiah to express the really remarkable sense of aloneness and desolation that sometimes your servants feel, so that we know that when we feel that, we'll understand that. We're in good company. Jeremiah is the absolute best company we could be in. So Lord, help us to be faithful no matter what we face. Help us not to sink under discouragement. The devils would love it. The angels would the good angels would cry out and want good. So, Lord, you be our helper. We thank you for hearing our prayer and being our help. Even in times of the deepest despondency, we look to you. Our eyes are upon you, and in Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Our eyes are upon the God of heaven, and he has the help you need today.